music that's playing right now once the episode is edited. So we're not hearing it, but it's awesome, and we hope you guys like it.
Such a good intro song.
Yeah. Welcome to another fantastic episode of At The Bar Podcast. Once again, I'm your host, Mike. With me today, as always, he hasn't interrupted me yet, so he's on. This is two for two. We have Jeff, a.k.a. Mr. Hollywood.
Hi. I didn't want to interrupt you, so I didn't say hi.
Good.
Hi.
Got sunglasses on and his hat backwards. That's what's up.
Backwards hat today. Yeah. Very Hollywood.
And joining us yet again, I think he's our most...
I'm pretty sure I've sat on like the past
You're in like half of our episodes.
Yeah, I am.
The stoner of the show.
I don't even do drugs.
It's Goose. What's up, man?
What's going on? I'm glad you think I'm a stoner.
You know, he seems like a stoner, but he doesn't do drugs. But then he says words like cowabunga.
You sound like a stoner.
I know I do. I can't help it. My eyes don't open completely. My attitude.
I say tight a lot, though, so.
Well, you're just also a douche. Like
that's good. That's a fair point.
Tight, dude. And you're a douche.
It's a little windy today, so we hope you guys can hear us fine. I think we'll be all right.
Yeah,
we should be fine.
So it's Cinco de Drinko.
Cinco of... Cinco of Mayo. You have to eat mayo with everything today.
Do we have mayo?
Just like America.
Mayo shots.
We should do mayo shots after each beer we drink.
We got some different varieties.
I don't want to do that.
I got some IPA sauce, which is a mayo base. Some sriracha, mayo base.
No. I don't want to do that. That's crazy. You're drunk. So it's Cinco de Mayo, and we are not drinking Mexican beer. Everyone relax. We're drinking Sixpoint.
Yeah. We're weird. We do a Cinco release of a New York brewery instead.
So, Jeff, why do we have Sixpoint?
I don't know.
Because they're awesome. Brewery spotlight. Jeff doesn't know.
No, I mean, I know we have a spotlight on. Okay. I thought you were asking me what's the motivation behind having a brewery spotlight on Cinco de Mayo.
I mean, that's also a good question.
Oh, the reason we do that is because it gets people in on Cinco de Mayo.
Oh.
And everyone else is going to go to, like, library and stuff and get...
So Sixpoint must be like that hot of a brewery to...
Or just what
Sixpoint's a great brewery.
Yeah, they are.
It's great. Yeah, I know.
It's what Darren had available, I guess.
Do we have any Mexican beer on tap?
We do. Yeah, we have Corona. We have Modelo. We've got $1 off Mexican bottles and cans today. Some $4 Mexican drafts. $2 tacos.
How many tacos?
As many as you want.
I mean, they're $2 a piece, so you could get a 100 of them for $50, or $200. Math is not my strong suit.
Yeah.
I was thinking half off for some reason.
We haven't even started drinking it. You're already.
I was like half off for some reason in my head, but I'm like, nope, that's just $2. That's a finite number.
You said that, and I was like, yeah, that math seems right.
No one said anything.
I was just like,
that's good for word. Like, oh yeah.
Don't ever do that. If I say math, guys,
100 times
when I start talking about math, don't. I probably have said so many weird things about brewery buyouts, like with my math.
Yeah. So Boston's here, so we're going to assume that he's going to sprackly come in and be Boston.
Yeah, they're doing a fruit bottle share.
Yeah.
Fruit-inspired.
He should be coming in and out of the show.
Our Randall tonight would fit in with their bottle share pretty well.
Yeah, Fan Brewing's beer would.
Slammer.
This is about 6 point.
Jammer goes with serrano peppers, limes, and oranges all soaked in tequila. It's an interesting little ghost. Yeah. I like it.
So the tequila was good.
We're tweaking the show a little bit. We're gonna do two parts. This is gonna be part one, and part one is gonna be all about Sixpoint. Now, we have four beers from Sixpoint here. Do you know where in New York specifically?
No,
I'm not sure. I think down by the city, but I'm not.
You look it up real quick.
So while Goose is being a chap, we have. Sixpoint, four of them, like I said, we have their Bolshoi.
Bolshoi.
It's their Imperial Style at 10.2%.
Very tight.
The second beer we'll be having is the Sixpoint Double Sweet Action.
Woo, so good.
That is a strong ale at 9%. Third beer is a Sixpoint Global Warmer. It's a winter warmer in summer at 7%. And then the last one we're going to have is going to be Jeff's favorite. I'm predicting it right now. Sixpoint Little Raspy. It's a Berliner Weiss.
And it's a 4.7. Raspberry. It's a raspberry Berliner, so you know I'm going to hate it. But
no, you're going to love it. And the wind's blowing. All right, where are they? Goose.
Brooklyn.
Brooklyn.
Yeah.
Brooklyn.
Oh, that's cool. Actually, it's Garrett Oliver was just at our GM conference from Brooklyn Brewing, and he said that there's a lot of breweries right in Brooklyn in that like same area. They must be right by, like, I'm sure they're near each other.
Yeah,
I'd fit in perfectly in Brooklyn. Hipster douche, I'd work great.
Just anyway.
There, just like, we all just looked at him right, like, well,
I'm glad you guys don't like
did
my comments.
Did he just call him
like,
a
dude? Really love you, it's all right. Let's go into the Bolshoi.
Bolshoi.
Or I'm sure I'm fucking it up, whatever. I don't
it's
care.
It's the dark one. It's an Imperial Stout, someone so it's the only one that looks stouty.
Who cares?
Oh, you're talking about the pronunciation?
Yeah.
Pronunciation?
Bolshoi. What? We're off to an awkward start.
I don't know. Goose is calling me out because I said pronoun instead of pronunciation.
You said pronunciation.
Pronunciation.
What the fuck's happening? All right. This is what happens when we take a week break. Everything's
I don't know.
Apart.
Hipster douche over here is being mean to me.
With his Napa Smith brewery hat. What the fuck is that?
Dude, you get free hats. You wear them.
So what's,
you don't like Napa Smith?
I've never even heard of them.
Napa They're from Napa Valley.
Yeah.
I would have figured.
They're awesome. I've been there. I've been to that brewery. It's cool. Get a hop again. 144 IBUs. Double IPA.
How'd you get the hat?
Travis gave it to me.
Oh, okay.
So I get all my hats.
Who's Travis?
One of the reps.
Oh.
You don't know Travis?
How do you know
RNDC?
Travis?
He's
never
the coolest.
Met any of the reps here.
Dude.
Travis is a cool. Travis, what's up, man? You're
Ryan,
the coolest.
They're brewery reps, not distributor reps. Anyway, so what are you guys going to smell the Bolshoi?
Really coffee up front.
I don't know.
I'm getting a little
sweeter, caramelly, and chocolatey.
Yeah, I'm getting more of a, like a dessert, like a chocolate, a slight roast.
Yeah, roast light. Roast is probably what you're smelling because it is roasty.
Yeah, a lot of chocolate roast. It doesn't smell like a 10.2% at all.
Well, I already tasted it, and it doesn't taste like a
10.2%. No, it doesn't taste like a 10.2 at all.
Mouth feels lighter, too. My mouth feels 7% stout.
Taste I get a lot
is
of
7%
roast
stout.
Yeah, it tastes like a 7%. A lot of roast. Kind of thin.
A little thin
the body.
But a little bitey, like metallic-y. Not because there's nothing wrong with the beer. It's not like an off flavor. It just tastes that kind of.
It's just the way the malts transition. Yeah. I'm not too blown away by it. Not too blown away.
I wish it was a little more powerful. When you're buying a beer that's 10.2, you want it to
what
be
up,
pretty
girl?
Powerful. Ari, you want to hop on? You want to hop on the podcast?
Oh, no.
Oh, no, I'm good.
I need help.
All right, back to what we were doing.
All right.
Before I was so rudely interrupted.
I do get a little metallic to it.
Yeah.
It has to be the malt. Somewhat the way the malt.
It's not pronounced enough for me to think it's an off flavor in the beer. I think it was designed to be this way, but.
Goose, what are you thinking?
Same thing. It's too light for me to have like 10%. It won't more flavor to it, more thick.
Goose, Domingo needs you.
Little bit of Goose is going to step away for a second. I'm not big on it.
You know, the thing
every
is, if it, was
blows,
ad-
kind of panic.
If it was advertised as a 7% stout, I actually think it would be pretty good. But when you buy a beer that's 10.2%, you have expectations for that beer.
You need something to stand out. This, it kind of tastes like leather, like a canvas, kind of. I've never
licked a painting before, so I don't know what a canvas
tastes
like.
You don't
have to
lick a painting. You never like. Pass on a leather couch. I know you have.
Oh, I sleep on my couch every day.
So?
I sleep on my couch more than I sleep in my bed. My bed's upstairs. Why would I walk upstairs?
I don't know. Well, we got to go into ratings here. I don't want to spend too much time on this.
I'm going to let it warm up, but I'm going to give it a cold score now, and then we'll circle back, give it a quick recap later on. On a cold score... For an Imperial Stout style, it hits style, but it just doesn't have a whole lot of extra going on. I'm going to give it a 7.3.
Me too. I'm going to go in line with what you just said, except I'm going to go a little bit less. I'm going to go with a 7.0. I think it hits style, and that's
about it. Yeah, I mean, it's not going to be a D beer. It's a middle-of-the-road shelf beer that, you know. But then again, it's a 10.2%, so I'd be disappointed if I ordered this as an Imperial Stout.
Yeah, me too. And that's one of the reasons why I'm giving it a cold score is a 7. I mean, it is what it says it is, but it's not anything extravagant.
Unless they're going to treat it with something, it's pretty run-of-the-mill.
It's a base style, a base beer. So we'll wait for... Fuck them.
He's gonna be in the kitchen for a bit now. So
all right, so we'll just continue moving on. Goose is dead.
He's dead to us.
So the next one we have up is the 6-point double sweet action, which is probably the one I'm probably most excited for, other than the raspy, just to see her face. Oh, what's the ABV on this? This is...
You said 9-point something.
This is 9-something. As usual, I'm not prepared. ABV on the double sweet action, 9 flat. It's a strong ale.
Okay.
Which a strong ale is essentially... It's not a specific category of beer. It's just something that's higher in alcohol that they can't seem to characterize under craft beer categorization. So the smell on it.
Very, and it's got a nice nose, floral.
Yeah, it's very floral, which is surprising. You get more on the smell in this one than you did the Bolshoi. But it's very light floral.
It's not like Belgian-y, but very yeasty almost in the way it smells. I don't know. It's interesting.
It's like pulpy, nice bouquet, almost like an IPA. Without the hop.
A little bit of IPA without
the bitterness of the hops. We're going for the taste here.
Ooh. I guess with a name like Double Sweet, you would have to expect it to be sweet, but this is good.
This is fantastic. I really like this one. It's, to me, it reminds me of sweet potato casserole. Not necessarily on the flavor, but like, this would be weird, but like the smell for some reason. When I smelt it, I thought of sweet potato casserole.
It's syrupy. It's very, it has a lingering, it makes your mouth water. It's very, I don't know, almost barley wine-esque, but not as dry.
You get more booze on it, too. I can taste the booziness. It's like a Vienna lager with more fun. You get, like, that creaminess. You get the Vienna lager hop burst, but it doesn't necessarily linger, but it's, like, refreshing. So it's like a it reminds me of a Vienna lager, personally.
I can see that.
So what you want to do? Fuck it, just go in the scores, whatever.
This is much better. I don't really know. Stylistically, I mean, I guess it hits.
It's a strong ale. It's just like
an open style, kind of.
Yeah, it's an open style.
I'd give this like a mid-level B, so I would give it like an 8.5.
You categorize that for your palate would be an 8.5?
That's like a mid-level B to me on this beer. It's great.
Okay.
But it's not the upper end, high end, like super rare. I think it's just like a mid-level B.
This beer will get you fucked up.
Oh yeah, it's dangerous.
Yeah, it's a danger beer. I'm torn between. I'm on the fence between a C+ and a B-. I would get other beer before this one, but.
But this is the style. I think it hits the style and does well.
But what is a strong ale? Strong ale is just one of those categories that people just like it's a specialty beer. Like, what is that? You know, what is that?
Anything.
I'd give it a 7.9 C+. I like its light. I like it. I'm not in love with it. It's a C+.
I'm staying with my 8.5, but I mean, I can see where you're coming from.
And, editing these episodes, I think we're pretty liberal. I need to crack down on my scores because I think I'm way too, like...
I usually go way too high.
Passive.
Yeah.
I'll get down in a second. We'll wait. Yeah, so the 7.9 for the double sweet action. Good, but not great. So the next one we have... is the
Global Warmer.
Global Warmer, which is around 7%.
In a winter warmer.
It's a winter warmer here on May 5th in Orlando, Florida.
Yeah, it's a nice, like, well, it's actually a beautiful day. I don't...
Yeah, it's
It's really weird. It's
because
it's been 90. It's been, like, 98
it's
lately.
Been fuck,
it's
yeah.
been... this is nice. This is, like, mid-80s.
Yeah, it's really nice. It's just way windy. Clear blue skies. Not a cloud in the sky. Anyway...
That's because it rained for 28 straight hours starting 2 days ago.
So this beer smells like an IPA. I take that back. A pale ale.
Pale ale, but roasty.
Yeah.
Like a little bit of like, I don't know, smoky to the nose to me. I get
pine. I get a little bit of like a lemon.
Resiny. It's like a little resin.
lemon, a little bit of lemon, slight touch of orange. I mean, it's cloudy with a like a penny copper color. So, go in for the good stuff here. It's a pale ale. Hey, can you do me a solid, Brad?
Really, really unexpected dry finish.
It's super dry.
Yeah, like a rye. It's like a very like.
You don't smell like the rye on the mouth.
Like if you were
on the nose.
If you had a cold and really you had some mucus through in your throat, like this is you drink this and all of a sudden you can breathe again. Like that's like dries
it's
everything out.
It's like a rye
out.
Pale ale. How do you like it, Goose? Now that you're back.
I don't like it.
No?
No, I don't like it.
Which one?
The
global.
You don't like it? I like
it.
It's just very dry.
Okay. Yeah, it's dry and hoppy.
I'm not crazy about winter warmer, so I actually like that this is not stylistically perfect.
Yeah.
I prefer that.
They tend to be darker, too, in color. So we're gonna wait here for Goose to get more of a...
Oh, let's get Goose's catch-up. You got to do the other one. That's the double sweet.
What would you give the first one?
The first one, the...
Bolshoi.
Bolshoi. I think 8.2.
Okay.
All right. Split the difference.
Yeah.
It's solid beer. I drink
on that one, right? No, I didn't.
Poo-poo on it?
I did
a little poo-poos?
Did a poo-poo.
You did some poo-poos? No, you gave that a C. Or a 79 or 7.9.
No, I gave that a C. Yeah.
I thought you gave that a 7.9.
No,
Bolshoi.
I don't fucking remember.
We've had so many beers since then. We're like hammered now.
Yeah. Goose is on that double sweet. Sweet action.
It's got an interesting flavor to it.
Do you smell it?
Ooh, don't tell him our scores. I don't want him to just agree with us.
I don't remember what score I gave it.
I'm just going to fail everything.
Oh, wait. I do. I think I gave it the upper.
What style is that supposed to be?
Strong ale.
Oh, it's a strong.
Strong ale.
Which means it's just a higher alcohol beer that they can't put in a category.
Yeah.
It's an ale, though.
It's an ale.
At least it's in that category.
Yeah.
Aren't all beers ales? Ales are lagers.
Ales are lagers.
This is a nice tasting lager, right?
I like the people that come in. Give me any ale.
I really like ales.
We have 36 ales.
Let me find one for you.
What do you think of the double sweet?
I don't think it's anything special.
Okay.
I think it's like 7.
It's just a beer.
Yeah, it's like 7.3.
Ooh, a low-si.
Okay.
I think he even poo-pooed on that more than you did.
He poo-pooed. Yeah, he did. Yeah.
Yeah.
I think I poo-pooed on the, I can't remember.
Damn, I don't want to be like the liberal grader again.
Jeff, for being the socialist, everything's getting some.
Just for showing up.
Yeah, just for showing up.
Free scores.
Yeah, free scores. Well, for being here or not, you're getting an extra 2 points, which is, I'm going to give you an 8.5. So what do you graded the winner, the global?
No, I didn't grade. I haven't graded the global warmer yet.
We're waiting on you, bro.
I know you're waiting on me. That's why I'm taking my time.
All right.
Try it again, even though I don't like it.
Come on, Goose.
It's like a 7.5, 7.6.
Do we even go through the global?
I don't think so.
Just regrade it anyway.
I'd give it a 7.4.
All right.
It's a C beer.
Oh, we didn't give it scores yet.
Okay, no. I'd give the, what the fuck we just had.
I'm going to give it a 9.1.
Really?
Damn.
I'm totally fucking with you.
Very liberal over here.
No, I just wanted to go into that whole socialistic vibe. No,
everything is
global warmer, so winter warmer 7%. I give it a 7.4. It's like, it's good.
Yeah, it's good.
The thing is, all these beers so far have been like, if I ordered them, I wouldn't be upset, but I wouldn't be blown away either. So all of them are like mid-level C's. I gave one of them a mid-level B, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, you gave
the double sweet.
The double sweet, yeah. You gave that an 8.5.
I think this is like a 7.6 is what I would give it. Like a mid-level
mid-C.
C.
I think we all gave that a mid-C.
Yeah.
Hopefully this little raspy saves the tasting here.
Yeah, right?
Maybe we'll find a beer that... The past you've just tasted like weird versions.
I mean, the
of
good
resin,
news is
so.
if we don't get one that's a good one out of these four, we're leaving it up to Raspy here. We do have resin on tap, so we could just go get a resin and give it a good score.
I don't like resin.
Resin's amazing.
Everyone's had resin.
I know that's the reason we didn't want to do it.
I'm just gonna get the jammer, Randall.
Jammerandal is amazing.
Yeah.
It's a bias opinion.
You just have to add stuff to make 6 point good,
so
apparently.
The Little Raspy is a 4.7% Berliner.
Ooh, smells twice. Good.
It has, it's a little pinkish, so that's come from the raspberries. So color is spot on. Jeff, don't nod your head in disappointment.
It just smells like cheese. It smells like raspberry Cheez-Its.
Most interesting flavored Cheez-Its.
I mean, I would say it smells like a raspberry-flavored Sour Patch Kid, but I guess cheese, whatever, Cheez-Its.
Nah, cheese, straight cheese.
No.
Like a... It
smells tart.
Like
raspberry,
a stinky Gouda.
Tart raspberry. That's what it smells like. Don't listen to Jeff. He doesn't know he's talking. He's an obscure host.
Hey, dude, he's a shitty GM. Literally, you just spit on the table.
Oh, wow.
That's not impressive.
At least the aftertaste is a little bit better.
With this is just straight like warm raspberry like concentrate.
Do you taste the cheese now?
No, I don't taste cheese.
No,
sour,
I don't taste cheese either.
You're on your own on that one, yeah.
Like
Berliners taste like cheese.
No,
they're the only sours that do.
I'm pretty sure they're the only person that.
Yeah, I'm not the only person. I tell you that for a fact. David Boston thinks Berliner Weisses taste like stomach bile.
Why is he tasting stomach bile? Oh, okay.
Like if you, throw up in your mouth.
Yeah.
I agree with that more than it saying it tastes like cheese.
Yeah, I would agree. Yeah.
I think they taste like Cheez-Its, man. Hey, it's my palate. Get the fuck off.
Coming from Mike, who's like, everything tastes like oranges.
Well, you're the one with such a unique palate that a third of everything you bring out, you just shit on because you don't like it. That was word for what you said to me like a couple episodes ago.
Wait, what did I do?
I think it was my birthday one. You were like, yeah, two-thirds of everything we bring out Mike fucking hates because he has a weird palate. I'm like, no, bitch, just one-third.
I don't know. You just really don't like IPAs.
I'm just specific. IPAs would grow on me very fast.
Yeah.
Shout out to Dogfish Romantic Chemistry, which I haven't opened that bottle yet. But this beer is not a very good Berliner, in my own opinion.
I like Berliners, and that's not good.
I'd rather have Red Cypress's
Fruit de la Terre
than this.
I liked Fruit de la Terre.
Yeah.
It wasn't even a Berliner.
Not that Fruit de la Terre is a shitty beer. I would rather have oranges in my beer than this raspberry sour.
I think most people would agree with you.
Yeah.
Because oranges are delicious.
So, in going with the score here for the Little Raspy.
Talk shit about Mike's palate for another 5 minutes.
It hits style.
Yeah, it tastes cheesy enough for me to consider it a Berliner.
6.9. D+. I think the aftertaste falls short.
I think it's unfair for me to grade this one.
Hey, listen, fuck off is still a score. It's in the video of my birthday. I substituted your 5 and put fuck off.
I have a disdain for this style.
This beer is not a fuck off though.
It's not a fuck off.
No, it's not. It's just not.
But when
good.
If you saw the face I made when I took that sip, it was almost a fuck off.
You spit on the table.
No, I didn't.
No,
I didn't spit on the table.
Stuff sprayed out.
I just saw it happen. That's what she said. Like a gleek. I gleeked on the table.
Jeff had a leaky mouth.
I will give this. I will give this a 5.8.
Okay.
I'm going to give it almost a D. Almost a D.
Almost a D.
Almost a D. But not quite.
Pretty much what I've given every one of my girlfriends. Almost a full D.
It's like that conversation we had earlier.
I'm gonna cut
if they've
that,
already taken you home.
Cut that section off and just keep it.
If they've already taken you home, it's too late.
Yeah, well, that's a true statement.
One of these episodes, I'm going to make an episode full of Jeffisms. And that's one of them. Just like all my
that should be the second segment of this episode.
There's just
things like that. You just the girl's pot committed. She's not going home at that point.
Okay.
You could have a giant wiener or a tiny wiener. It doesn't matter. They're already there.
So Jeff gives this beer a partial.
Partial.
This beer gets a semi chub from me.
New score.
Like a half effort.
Boner length. This gets just short of a half chub.
This gets like whiskey dick from
I was about to say whiskey dick is the better term.
It gets so almost a full D, but not like almost there.
It's like you kind of want it, and you're, nah.
I gave this beer a quarter chub. Goose, what kind of beer does it? What kind of chub does this beer get? What
kind of chub? I don't, that's a hard one. You already used quarter.
That is a hard
one. We got a quarter chub and a half chub. I don't be like.
No, mine is a quarter chub. He has whiskey dick.
Yeah,
he gave it a 5-point
like
whiskey dick.
I think one with like.
That's unusable.
That's just there, but you can't use
that's
it.
That's just pushing rope.
Flopping around, you know.
You're just pushing rope.
Jeff gives this beer a floppy dick score.
I mean, this is like I'm gonna give this one like I took a handful of like pain medicine, blood tooth in to get
Vicodin
a boner.
Vicodin D. So what kind of F is that?
What kind of F is that? That's the good kind of F.
That's the kind of F that gets your girlfriend to break up with you.
Is that what happened?
I don't know.
Okay, what's the score? Good goddamn.
No, I'm giving this like a 6.2.
Okay.
At least you made it to D.
Yeah, at least they made the D.
Yeah.
All right, so we're gonna take a break and compose ourselves.
Stay talk tuned. More about whiskey dick.
Yeah, stay tuned for part two. We're doing something a little bit different, and I'm excited. We'll be back. This is Mike from At The Bar Podcast, and we got Jeff over here, too. We're the guys from At The Bar Podcast.
That's us.
So this is our first official commercial for the show. We're doing things differently. So with moving forward, me and Jeff have decided that we're going to offer companies sponsorship packages. Jeff,
correct.
Tell them
yeah.
about it.
All right, so what we're going to do, we're either going to do just small segments or full show sponsorships. We, you know, kind of want to get the word out about what you guys are doing, and we have the reach to do so. So we figured we'd, you know, kind of try to partner with who we can and see if anybody's interested in doing, you know, something with our show and getting the word out about what they're doing. So if you're looking to hook up with us and get a sponsorship, like I said, we're doing segments so you can have portions of the show or full show sponsorships. The rates will be, you know.
Affordable. We do, you know, everything a la carte. Anything you want us to do, we can essentially do. Whether it's hand out merchandise at the bar here or wear your merchandise on the show or take pictures or full segments, like you said. So we have, you know, everything really customizable, and we're pretty open, you know. We're a fast-growing podcast. We're the number one craft beer podcast in Orlando.
Yeah.
And we have a lot of big things going on, and we want you guys to be a part of it. So if you want to be a part of the show, contact us at thebarpodcast@gmail.com. Or if you're listening to the show on iTunes, Stitcher, or Google, just find us on social media and reach us there.
Yep, absolutely.
So looking to hear from you guys soon, and keep drinking. And we're back. Part two. We're going to have some fun.
Yeah.
We're going to have some fun.
What's part two?
This is part two.
What are we doing on part? Yeah.
And Goose, I want you. You can play, too.
I can play.
You can play, too.
We like playing.
So we're doing something different. I'm going to call this segment Nothing Original, Buy or Sell. So pretty much those who are not familiar with what buying and selling is in terms of...
It's capitalist society.
Yeah. Hey, listen.
Pretty much what?
It's all about feel that burn. All about socialism.
Oh, my goodness.
So pretty much what buying and selling is...
That was better.
I'm going to ask a question or an event, or I'll bring up a topic, right? And I'm going to ask Jeff and Goose, buy or sell. Buying means you support it, you think it's a good idea, and you have an opinion on why it's a good idea. If you say sell... Pretty much saying sell means you think it's a bad idea or it won't work.
Great opportunity to get more controversial on our show.
Right. So, what in the fuck is on TV?
We're watching a cartoon right now. I'm very into this cartoon.
So, all right, guys.
Yeah, the dog's talking.
I have one, two, I have.
All right, let's
five,
do it.
Five topics. Buy or sell.
Five topics. All right.
This is for all of us.
I'm fired up. I'm ready to roll on.
That's already
are
too
you
much.
Excited?
That's too much for me.
And you guys don't know my topics, so these are going to be. Very surprised.
I'm going to probably disagree with Goose on every one of them so that this segment goes an hour and a half long.
All right. Well, I hope it doesn't.
Halfway anyway. Through each one, though, I'll change my mind to agree with you,
no, you
so
can't.
We can continue it longer.
All right, guys. Here we go. Buy or sell. Dogfish revealing a new packaging and starting canning. And we'll start canning. Buy or sell.
Buy.
Jeff, what do you think?
I don't know. The jury's out. Let's hear Goose's rationale.
All right. Why do you think it's why you buy it?
I've always canning's a better process for the beers. It's always been better.
Okay. They're revealing a new packaging. I don't know specifics, but they're having some craft beer conference in Philly as we speak. And this is when it was
to go
announced.
Over their packaging?
Yeah.
It's weird.
It's important. Well,
they're releasing some sort of either a new design or new formula or whatever, but Dogfish is finally starting to can. So
I think canning is a good idea. The packaging might change that.
I mean, packaging is your first point of sale to me. Yeah. The thing about Dogfish Head is I know they've worked with an artist for a long time who's done a lot of their label work. I think almost all of their label work. He used to make their tap handles as well. Have you ever seen the one with the shark coming out of the water?
Yeah.
And great. They've worked with that artist. So I hope that's, you know, that's kind of been how you distinguish them. They have great packaging already. Now, going to can, you have to adapt your packaging and make it cooler. They have a great reputation. I don't know about rebranding anything, so I'm going to sell on rebranding. Canning is great. Buy canning. Rebranding and changing anything.
Rebranding. They're just the article when I looked said they reveal new packaging.
I'll buy.
You'll buy?
I'll buy
too.
Yeah.
Just because I think Dogfish is smart enough to research how their beers are going to adapt to cans before they even release it. So I'm buying that.
What Sam's a genius. He knows.
Same thing. I know. That's what I said.
My
fucking
hero.
Yeah. Buying the canning.
100%.
Yeah.
I am curious in how the cans are going to look and how the beers are going to taste. Is there something on my shoulder?
If they can do it right, canning is better for the beer. So.
Yeah.
Okay. Next topic, guys. Buy or sell. Oskar Blues is now in 50 states. They just got into Montana.
I like how Montana was the last state.
Buy or sell Oskar Blues.
I'll be buying that. I think we all knew it was coming when they got bought by Constellation. They were already
Oskar Blues?
No, Ballast Point got
bought. Ballast Point, that's right. Oh, Oskar Blues.
Hey guys, it's David. Are we on?
Yeah, you're on.
Are we? Woo! Titty. He just saw Titty.
Jeff, shake his hand.
He just literally flashed us his tits.
We've got Main Beer Company dinner.
Okay.
Yes.
For you and Jeff. Sorry, I didn't know you were out here.
Yeah. But, that's harsh.
We can share that. It's three ways.
Yeah, you guys can share it however you want. Let's see what you think here.
Eight point three.
I don't know what that means.
It's a B beer for me.
Okay, that's fine.
Yeah, the flavor. You know what? Flavor's not. It doesn't pack enough of a punch for me.
It's got a upfront citrus taste. It's nothing.
You know, listen. You guys need to pull your fucking tampons out and let's just fucking drink some beer, okay?
You're aware that's not one of the better beers that you've brought.
Main Beer Company? That's fucking delicious.
Well, Main Beer Company's good.
It's good, but it's not worth the hype.
What hype?
To be fair, I didn't know there was
Everyone
hype.
Everyone wants dinner. Main Beer dinner.
Yeah, that's what it is, guys.
Yeah.
It's pretty good.
Oh, hi.
I like it.
Sorry.
Solid.
It's all right.
No, it's good.
It's all right.
I love your tits, David.
Fair, that's I love your tits.
Thank you.
And that's a right. Classic boss.
Is that why he's not on the show anymore?
No, he's he got a promotion. He's better than all of us, all right?
He got an actual promotion at work and has been hard to get a hold of lately. Yeah, that's pretty much. I'd love to have him on the show more.
So Oskar Blues, go back to what.
I'm sorry, cut me out when I said that Constellation thing. That was dumb.
Oskar
Blues, I don't know. I just thought we always talk about Ballast Point.
Now hit 50 states. They just got into Montana was their last state. Buy or sell. Point two is they're distributing in Australia in 2017. Buy or sell.
Wow.
Oskar fucking Blues.
Does anybody own them? No.
No, they own Cigar City now. But yeah, I'll buy.
Layman's terms, they own Cigar City.
Okay. I'll buy. They opened up an East Coast brewery. It was inevitable. They were going to start distributing on a bigger scale. They need to. They are a top 10 brewery in the country, and they need to be in all 50 states. It doesn't make sense that they're not. So.
Well, now they are. So.
Just yellow mustard.
Goose sells too. Or buys
too. Yeah, I'm buying. Yeah, I'm buying. I think it's good for craft beer that they did it on their own. They didn't get bought out and made it in every 50 and made it in all the states and soon to be Australia.
I'm buying that too. To my knowledge, Oskar Blues has never lost quality. So to me, that's very important in not only being available in your own state, but being available in now 50 states to keep that quality is a feat. To get.
Side note, I don't know if they're ever going to do it, but there's been a huge call for a 10-50 Hunapu blended collaboration now that Oskar Blues and Cigar City are in the same family.
Ooh, that'd be good.
So we're talking about a Huna. I don't think it'll happen either, but a Huna 10-50 would be pretty good.
Sounds good. As long as it's not this year's Hunapu. Hopefully they fix that.
Thought so.
So anyway, all right. So we all buy on that, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Buy or sell, guys. Boston Beer Company revenue is down 5% in Q1.
I don't even know who Boston Beer Company.
Sam Adams.
Sam
I
Adams.
Sell. You can. You want me to go into
sell?
The, buy or sell? What do you think? I sell.
I buy. I would buy now and sell later.
I don't think
I'm buying it.
I
fucked up. Big.
I think they did too.
They
I
made
think
a big mistake.
I think with their whole like nitro can line, I think that was a bad idea. That's the Sam Adams, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that a lot of that business is because of that craft scandal that's in New England, and I think that,
that's why I'm
and I
it.
Think that that is that they're not. I think those are skewed numbers. I think that's because of that whole thing that Boston Beer Co. took a hit in their hometown, essentially of New England, and that's probably at least 5%, probably way more than 5% of their sales comes from New England, and. I think that they're struggling for distribution in their own area right now because the craft distributor fucked up and they carried everybody up there. And, you know, I don't think it's a big thing for them. And I mean, it can't be that big of a deal if they're buying more breweries.
You're true. You're right. You're right. I'm buying because I think that what happened with what you just said has a trickle down effect and that it's messed with everybody now. And, you know, you have those people that are going to be vengeful and immature. So, you know what? Well, Boston, Sam Adams fucked me over. I'm never buying a Sam Adams beer again. Which, I mean, that's their prerogative. But I think I'm buying it now. I think that number, I think we're going to lose more money. But they're not going to shut down. They're not going to go out of business. They're too big. But I think they're going to find a way to fix that problem and then boost revenue back up, probably more than what they had before. So I'm buying that.
Okay.
You're selling on that, Jeff.
Yeah, I mean, I think a lot of the problems that happened with that craft distributing thing was Sam Adams related. They were the big one that was paying for taps. They were the ones that could afford to do so. That whole thing with shutting down that distributor for a year was a year, right?
That was 3 months.
3 months, whatever it was, enough that you're screwed if you don't distribute in that area. So I think that them being part of the issue is going to close a lot of doors that they previously had open to buy taps and have permanent taps at places and things like that. Also, their reputation took a hit, but they are still buying other breweries. So I think they're getting to the point where they're going to be taking a Sam Adams approach, or not a Sam, a freaking AB approach and start buying up other smaller breweries to offset market share.
Yeah.
You know?
But you're still selling.
Yes.
On that. Okay. Buy or sell, guys. Terrapin's now releasing a watermelon Gose in cans. Buy or sell.
I'm going to buy that.
Okay.
Like you're actually going to buy that beer?
I would actually buy that beer.
I'm going to sell. I think Gozes are a great beer. I think watermelon usually tastes either like candy or like nothing in a beer. It's a hard flavor to put into a beer. A Gose stands on its own, and you don't need to be putting a flavor like that into a beer. Now, it's trendy, and people like watermelon, so I get what they're doing, and they'll probably sell a lot of it. But I've seen a lot of their stuff sit on shelves for a long time. Maggie's Cobbler is still on shelves now.
Yep.
To me, the execution would have to be perfect, and that's a hard flavor to put into a beer. So I am selling. I think it's not going to be a well-received beer.
And why are you buying Goose?
Because I think the opposite. I think all their flavored stuff, like the Maggie's Peach and like their Blackberry Call, I think they hit the point on that with those beers. And I think they have the chance to actually brew that well. And actually, unlike the Anderson Valley watermelon goes, where that actually is just awful. Like, it's not bad.
Well, that's
but
my point. And then, I mean, most watermelon beers taste like feet.
Terrapin has the... Terrapin's better than most, and they can do a better job.
I mean, arguably, Terrapin has struggled to do flavors well. A lot of people don't receive their flavors very well.
I'm selling, and here's why. I think the whole watermelon craze is a gimmick. I think it's going to be like a session IPA. It's going to come and go, just like hard sodas. It's going to come and go.
Thank God they're gone.
I think Terrapin overproduces their one-offs to where they have the same effect I think Southern Tier does, is that they make so much of it and it sits on the shelf for so long that the beer either goes bad or they have to buy it back or something along those lines. I mean, in the last couple of years, when you go to a Total Wine or an ABC, like, how often do you see a pumpkin, like a whole stack of them? You know, 5 months after.
Warlock is still on the shelves in a lot of places from last year.
Yeah, 5-6 months later. Because they either, A, it's not good enough, which I don't think pumpkin is, but that's besides the point. I think they produce too much of their one-offs, and it makes their one-offs not highly sought after because you can get it anywhere. So, the Maggie's, Blackberry, they're all good beers, but there's too much of it. Now, Terrapin does not blow me away personally. I think they hit style. I think they have a couple beers that are good, but I don't think this beer is going to turn out special.
I think Wake and Bake and Tiramisuhu, it's going to hit style. I think their dark beers usually hit.
Oh yeah,
I think
they
when
do,
they
yeah.
try to go,
the Wake and Bake's their best series. In my opinion.
Black is the New Wit was not a great thing to go after. Terrapin uses rye in a lot, too many of their beers. Rye everything, and it's very dry. But I mean, a lot of their stuff is really great. The Terrapin event was amazing here. We had a ton of good stuff. The freaking coffee, the coffee beers, the four of them.
Were
incredible. The Wake and Bake series is incredible. Muhu series is also really great. I love their dark beers. Even Liquid Bliss is really good. But I think a lot of the lighter beers they miss on their flavors.
Yeah, I think it'll hit style. That one, it'll be you'll buy it. It's a warm. All right, on to the next one. That's what I think. So I'm selling on it. Last one, fellas, and personally my favorite.
Hard sodas.
A higher ABV Not Your Father's Root Beer will be hitting Nationwide Distro in 22 ounce bottles. Buy or sell? Jeff,
I called that. It
Bombers of 10.7% Not Your Father's Root Beer.
I think we're all going to sell.
I am going to hypocrite, but I'm actually in the position where I'm a hypocrite either way, because I specifically said that they need to put the higher ABV one into distribution when I was talking shit about craft sodas, because if you're going to drink 78 grams of sugar, it might as well have some alcohol in it. I buy because it will sell. I don't like it, and I still think it's a phase, and I think it will go away. But in the short term, buy. In the long run, sell all day. This craft soda thing's going to last a year.
Okay.
I mean, it already has died, pretty much.
It's selling really well, man.
It's selling a lot slower.
Not Your Father's is like the number one bought six-pack, according to Nielsen.
When? It hasn't. We don't sell that shit anymore at all. We still have it on the shelves. Yeah, it doesn't move.
I mean, you're talking about the whole nation. Not just, you know, here at WAB UCF.
If anybody's buying craft sodas, the bar by the campus is going to be selling a lot of sodas.
Number one six-pack. Goose, buy or sell?
I'm going to sell. I think it's going to, when it comes out, it's going to be popular for, like, a little bit. But then after that, it's just going to die out.
How far you think it's going to die out? I think it's dying out, personally.
Well, I think that individual, that high ABV, Not Your Father's, is going to last 3 months. You're going to buy it because it's going to be interesting and new, but then you're going to be like, this isn't good.
I want to go back to that episode and look at our predictions. I think I said July.
I think we all said November. I think we all said like 6 to 7 months.
I'm curious to see. I think it's already dead, even though it's the number one selling six pack. I think it's already dead.
It's dying, for sure. It's in the fast-paced regression mode.
So I am selling this for one reason. I think they waited
too long.
8 months too long.
Yeah, if they were to like come out 3 months ago at their peak, it would have been great for them. It would have extended the hard soda craze for a little bit longer. But
I disagree. I think that what they did was they hit the market. They were the fastest selling. I mean, they were the fastest growing brewery in the country, highest sales. They, like you said, number one six-pack.
Yeah.
And then as they're seeing regression, they say, what do we have to do to keep these sales? And that's why they're releasing it now. So I think this is their last-ditch effort to get a revamp in sales. And then you know what's going to happen is they're going to hit that, wow, this 10.1 whatever came out, and now we're going to sell a bunch of it. And then all of a sudden, we're going to then again see a regression, and then they're going to release something else. And something they're going to become a one-off release, three-month sales bust and then they're going to fall. You know what I mean? Like, that's what they're going to be.
I believe they've already announced either a cream soda or an orange cream soda. One of the two. They've already announced. I don't know if it's out yet.
Thank God, because cream soda is the best.
They announced it.
Cream soda is good. I forgot. There's one of them. I don't remember their name. Another hard soda. They're doing a Mountain Dew.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. So I'm still selling. I mean, you're talking about something that's super high in sugar. It's 10.7% alcohol, and it's a 22-ounce bottle. That's a lot.
Yeah, that's
not only a lot of sugar, that's a lot of alcohol for 22-ounce bottle.
That's another thing, though, too. I don't like the bomber format in that release.
No.
That's a bad idea for...
Because, you want it to sell quickly.
Well, bomber format is fantastic if you're selling to beer people, because beer people understand the price point on a bomber.
Yeah.
Like, a person who's drinking not your father's root beer doesn't understand why it's $16 for one bottle. But a person who drinks craft beer understands why a one-off 10% rare beer is higher. So I think bomber format is a really stupid play.
I think it's stupid, too.
Because they should be selling that in four packs.
Yeah. Four-pack bottles or cans?
Four-pack cans for $12.99.
Yeah, I agree. But you're also buying on this topic, even though you're sticking up for the selling aspect.
I pretty much have talked about why it's stupid the whole time, but then I've been buying. I don't know. Fuck craft sodas.
And that's it, guys. That is buying or selling. That was a good idea.
I liked it.
It is different.
I like it.
Yeah, it was good.
We can do that.
Side note, should Pete Rose be in the Hall of Fame buy or sell? Buy.
Buy. 1,000% buy.
Pete Rose should be, yeah. Of course he should be.
Buy.
Greatest hitter of all time.
Unanimous.
There's no.
Like, he took steroids, guys. He just bet on baseball. It's all
there's no
real
baseball fan ever that would say that he shouldn't be. I think. I mean, he what he did was incredible.
I think it's funny, and obviously this is not going to be about craft beer, and that's okay. But they allow MLB has a policy: if you get caught cheating, taking illegal substances, you get what, 280 game bans, and then a lifetime ban.
You got an 80-game ban, you get a season ban, and then a lifetime ban.
Right. So what Goose said, 80-game, you get called once, 80-game, twice it's a season, three times, you're banned for life.
Yeah.
Pete Rose, to our knowledge, never took illegal substances. He bet money on fucking baseball.
On his own team.
And the interesting thing is...
He never bet against his own team.
And even, like, every game he bet on his own team, you could see, like, if you were to look at his stats, you would never see he had, like, he didn't play well enough to try to, like, he always top performed.
Dude, his statistics speak for themselves, like...
It's ridiculous. Has the most hits of all time. Let the dude in the hall...
I get it. I mean, you don't want players betting on baseball.
Yeah.
But, like, are you going to literally tell me that there's players who are not in fantasy baseball leagues? That's a fucking joke. Of course they are.
No, and they're really, like...
And that shit is betting. That's money. I don't give a shit if you say it's not. It is. As anybody
it's
else...
It's a form of betting.
It's a form of betting.
Whether it's monetary or not.
Well, I guarantee in the players' contracts...
I'm sure it's money.
I'm sure in the players' contracts, it's betting.
Yeah.
I'm sure that counts. 100%. And I guarantee they still play it. But are any of them not getting in the Hall of Fame or getting suspended from baseball for it? No, because it's fantasy baseball, so it's a gray area.
No,
it's either betting or it's not. And I get what he did was wrong, but it didn't affect his play.
The fucked up thing about that whole thing with Pete Rose is they always, like, every time there's, like, a ceremony, it's like the 50 greatest players of the past 50 decades. They invite him to come out. They always, like, he's going to be at the All-Star Game in Cincinnati this year. They keep asking him to come to these events, and he's like, I can't go to actual games. They won't let me. But meanwhile, they keep asking me to come to these events because who I am and what I've done for the sport.
Right.
Like, and it just, he's like, just let me in the, let me just back to the games. He's like, I don't care about the
what
Hall of Fame.
What do you
Fame.
Think about his commercial? I thought his commercial was the funniest thing.
Oh, the Skechers commercial where he's
it?
Walking down the hall and he's just
and
like.
He's in the hall in his house and his wife's like, or I don't know if it's a wife or whatever.
His maid.
Whatever. She's like, Pete, get out of the hall. And he's like, man, not even at home?
Yeah. Like. No, it sucks that the dude is just, like, limited to selling autographs to make a living. Like,
I like the fact that every time I see him in public, like, on TV, he always wears a flat-brim hat. Like a real man.
Yeah.
What's really funny is he doesn't look like an athlete at all.
No, not anymore.
He doesn't look like an ex-athlete. Like, no. He just looks like a weird old man.
It looks like someone who got kicked out of his favorite sport and just started drinking heavy for 30 years.
He owns restaurants. I mean, he has income. He has, like, a chain of restaurants.
Oh, he's making a shit
ton of money. Pete Rose's place.
Yeah, it's still.
Should be in the hall.
Yeah, should be in the hall.
Yeah, but still.
What the fuck? When you let Barry Bonds become a coach. Yeah, they won't even let Pete Rose in the guy.
How great is it that Barry Bonds becomes a hitting coach for the Marlins and D. Gordon gets busted for steroids the first year Barry Bonds is there?
Oh, my God.
That shit's awesome.
I didn't even think about that. I forgot about it.
That shit's awesome. I don't care if it's a coincidence. It's freaking awesome.
So, yeah, we're gonna go into the ending of the show. There's no more plug-in anywhere, guys. I hate to break it to you.
Yeah, if you thought that was great, we're ending plugs.
We can plug with baseball stats.
You have them?
Not right now.
No, okay. So this episode has been sponsored by I can't talk now.
Wobble UCF.
Yeah. Wobble.
This episode has been sponsored by the first annual Homebrew Fest here at World of Beer UCF.
Boston's back for the closeout. All right, gentlemen. That looks like green. That looks like.
It's called Up a Creek. It is a barrel aged sour blonde ale.
Ooh, I'm in.
This has
looks like bile.
Has a lot of lemon and cherry. It's lemon and cherry.
Ooh, skip Jeff. He won't like it.
It really looks like sewer water. Just but I'm gonna give it a shot.
You should have saw the protein that was at the bottom of the bottle.
Why didn't we get that? I love sediment.
It smells so good.
It was almost vomit looking greenish brown.
I don't like the tart on it. I like
ooh,
everything.
I like the nose.
Good. That is it's kind of weird. It's a nice calm sour. It's not overly bare. Yeah.
I love it.
Yeah,
that is good.
I love it. That's a fucking.
It's got a 3.49 on Untappd. It doesn't make any sense out of a possible 5.
I'm surprised you're drinking it, right?
You know why?
You only drink 4s or more.
Somebody brought it. It was 2011.
You know why though? Because it looks like puke.
No, it was.
That's a 5-year-old beer, man.
So it's mild.
I like it. It's good.
I like it. It's pretty good.
Hey, look, the house is here.
Tequila. Are we doing tequila shots?
Not here because we don't have a liquor license and we don't do that here.
I know.
So this episode was sponsored by World Beer UCS first annual Homebrew Fest, June 25th of this year. Jeff, break it down for me.
We're just continuing to freaking destroy this thing. It's taken over my life, but we have new sponsors.
Is that a bad thing? Seriously?
Oh, no, good.
You butthurt about it?
Good. No, okay, great good. Thing. I'm loving it. Tons of sponsors coming on board. We have... actually, one of our brewers is going to be from a homebrew store in Orlando, so he's going to be doing
that,
some...
Yeah. Sanford.
Yeah. No, it's not Sanford. It's the one in downtown Orlando. And Sanford Homebrew will be there, too. But we got some people. World of Beer Corporate is getting involved, and they're involved in the Brewers Association, so we're going to be getting our advertisement out through the Brewers Association, trying to reach some people that are maybe otherwise not going to be involved in the Central Florida area, but with Sunshine Challenge jumping on board with us as well. Thank you for that, guys, and Central Florida Homebrewers. I mean, it's been awesome. It's growing very quickly. Everything is getting to the point. We're done with signing up brewers. We have 24 total brewers. It's going to be huge. We had to change the entire layout of the event to make room for everybody. Tickets available on eventbrite.com. Check it out. Just search for World of Beer UCF or WOB UCF or Homebrew Festival. It'll come up if you search anything UCF related for homebrewing. But it is, it's going to be a huge event. I'm really excited about it. Should be freaking insane. So good.
Cool. So yeah, guys, make sure you buy your tickets, $20, or you can drink from 3 to 6. Jeff will be here. I will be here. A bunch of us will be here. So yeah, this episode is sponsored by that event and all the people associated with it. Thank you very much. Goose, any last words?
Am I allowed to plug stuff?
Yeah, go ahead.
I don't have anything to plug.
Goose wants to plug the show, so you can find us at the Bar Podcast on all social media, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. I'll post a link on the video for YouTube. Other than that, just Google at the Bar Podcast. You'll find us. Breaking news. We are now available on Google Play.
That is cool news.
That is cool.
Yeah, look at
so
us.
Now you guys can listen to us on Stitcher, on iTunes, and on Google Play.
I only we Google Play. So cool.
We got y'all
maybe finally listen to the podcast.
Yeah. So that's the big news on our end, that we got reviewed and approved by Google to be on Google Play.
Jeff? Yeah, we are Google Play it.
So we're on 3 of the top 3 biggest internet radio websites.
Hey, listen, when you get on NPR, then I'll listen.
Or satellite. Oh, my God. It'd be my dream. So, anyway, that's this show, guys. Hope you guys had fun. Be sure to comment, email, any kind of questions or suggestions for the next episode. episodes.
Yeah, remember also when you're with your friends at the bar and you're rating beers to use the whiskey dick grading
always
scale.
Always use the dick system.
If they Boston Gabe came over with that Eclipse Vanilla, full-blown boner.
That's a throbbing erection beer.
Yeah, that's a rocket.
It's been 4 hours and I need to call a doctor.
Yeah, you took too much, Viagra. Until next time, guys, we'll see you at the bar.
Ooh, love that.